Silly Little Beaver Children's Books Read Aloud.
Don't Cry, Big Bird. By Sarah Roberts, illustrated by Tom Lee, featuring Jim Henson's Sesame Street Muppets. Big Bird liked to play with his friends, but playing with them was hard for Big Bird because their jump ropes were too short. Their hopscotch boxes were too small. Their hide and seek hiding places were too little. Their seesaws came down but never went up. One day, Big Bird came home from the park by himself. "I am too big to play with my friends," he sobbed. He was so busy crying, he did not see his friend, Snuffleupagus. "Don't cry, Big Bird," said Snuffleupagus. "You are not too big. Their games are too little." Big Bird jumped up. He stopped crying. "Do you really think so, Mr. Snuffleupagus?" "Yes, Bird, I really do," said Snuffleupagus. "You are a very nice size, big, like me." Then Big Bird had an idea. "Hey, we are both big, so let's play together," said Big Bird. Snuffleupagus shook his head. "No, Bird, I can't play now. It's time for my nap." And Snuffleupagus went slowly down the street. "It is nice to be big," Big Bird said sadly, "but sometimes I wish I could make myself smaller." Back at the park, Ernie and Bert were thinking, "If only Big Bird were smaller, then he could play with us," said Ernie. "Well, we can't make Big Bird smaller," said Bert, "but maybe we can make our games bigger, like this." They tied two jump ropes together. Grover ran to get Big Bird. "We have a big surprise for you," said Grover. When Big Bird got to the park, Ernie and Bert were turning the big rope. "Jump, Big Bird," they said. Big Bird jumped. The rope went over his head. "Hooray for Big Bird," they said. Everybody had a turn at jumping rope. Then Betty Lou drew the biggest hopscotch boxes ever. "Come on, Big Bird, hop," she said. Big Bird hopped. Then he looked down. "I did it right," he said. "I did not step on the lines. Hooray for me." Big Bird was really happy until he remembered something. "I'm still too big for hide and seek," he said. Then suddenly he smiled. "Hey, everybody," he shouted. "I do not have to hide. I can be it. I can look for you." Everybody played hide and seek, and Big Bird was it. Then they played on the seesaw. Big Bird sat on one end. All of his friends sat on the other. The seesaw went up and down. "What can we do now?" asked Harry. "Let's fly my new kite," said Betty Lou. She held the string and ran and ran and ran. The kite began to fly. It flew higher and higher until it hit the top of a tree. Bump! The kite fell down and stuck in the tree. "Oh no," cried Betty Lou. "I'll never get my kite back now." Big Bird ran to Betty Lou. "Don't cry," he said. "I think I can help." Big Bird stood on his tiptoes. He reached high up and pulled down the kite. "Here, Betty Lou," said Big Bird. "Your kite is as good as new." "Hooray for Big Bird," everyone cheered. Big Bird was very happy. "Now let's play my favorite game," he said. "What game is that?" everyone asked. Big Bird smiled. "Giant Steps." The end.
Thank you so much for going on that adventure with me. Please be sure to comment with your thoughts and subscribe to the channel. Enjoy the rest of your day. I'm gonna find something to eat now. Bye-bye.